It's time to beat the clock. Lights of Broadway, sights of Broadway, sounds of Broadway all around. And there above shines the name Sylvania, pioneer in light, sight, and sound. Finer products, better products, tested quality. Made for you by Sylvania, pioneer for half a century. Beat the clock, brought by Sylvania, beat the clock. To entertain ya, it's time to play Beat the Clock.
And here, replacing Bud Collyer, who is on vacation, is your old friend and guest clock watcher, John Reed King.
Welcome, everybody, to Beat the Clock, show where you can have the time of your life playing against time for big-time prizes. But right now, let's get over here and meet our first contestants. They were left over from last week, Mr. and Mrs. Edward Foy. Is that right? Where are you from, Mr. Foy? Come over close to the microphone.
From New York City.
And you are a fireman. I saw the show last week, and I heard you say you were a fireman. This is your wife. How long have you been married, Mrs. Foy?
15 and a half years.
15 and a half years. What do you do in the fire department, sir?
I'm a captain in a fire.
You're a captain, all right. Now, I want to explain this to you and to everybody watching and all the contestants who may be on the program later on. If a bell goes off during the program, that means that whoever is at the microphone at that point gets a chance to try for our bonus game, which is worth $200. You see the idea?
Yes, sir.
By the way, Mr. Foy, do you have any children?
Yes, three children.
Three children. Have you been on your vacation yet?
No, sir. You're going in December.
You're going in December. Well, you'll avoid the rush that way. Right? You've changed. And how
have.
You have. Well, we're going to go to the $100 clock right away, and you're all dressed for it, so step right out here. Do you ever play football?
No.
No. Have you ever played football, Mr. Foy? We're not going to play football today either, but we do need the helmets here. Which helmet is this? This is the man's here? All right, Mr. Foy. Oh, no, that's backwards. There we are. Good for you. And you have a helmet, too. This, what? We have earrings,
I can't
yeah.
Hear
yeah, all right. Now, we have these helmets on you for a protective reason, and I want you to step over behind your wife, put your arms around her waist, and... There we are. And now I want you to put your hands on his hands and don't use your hands at all in this stunt. The object is holding each other like that, not using your hands to touch these hoops at all. Can you hear me in there? Can you hear me in there? All right.
No.
Now, you have to crawl through the two hoops. You get the idea?
Are you kidding?
No, your husband's a fireman, you know.
Yeah, but.
Well, you're not, huh? All right. Now, let me see how much time we have. Let's look at the clock.
Are you kidding?
Yeah, there we are. 40, 55 seconds. What's that, Mrs. Bond?
Are you kidding?
No. You're going to love it, girl. Hands on your husband's hands there. All right. Here we go. Through the hoop. Ready? Go. No, you can't use your hands. All right. Through the hoop. No, you can't use... Oh, that's all right. Yes, but don't use your hands to touch the hoop. That's the idea.
Keep your... Get out of it?
You've got to get all the way through to win. Yes, ma'am. No, you can't use your hands. No, he's got to hold you right here. Now you've got to get through. There we are. All right. There we... You're going the wrong way. That's right. There we are, Mrs. Foy. There we are. No, you've got to hold your hands up here. There, because he's got to get through. See? There we are. Fine, Mr. Foy. Mr. Foy to the rescue when he's fired. Stop the clock. Let's explain that to you. I'm afraid I didn't too clearly. You can't use your hands, Mrs. Foy. This only happens once a week, you know. All right. Now, hands, there we are. Good. Now, all the way through the hoop. May I suggest that you step first to go through. I think you'll find that a little easier because these are on up and down. Yeah, all right, here we go. Ready, go. All right, start that clock again. Let's see whether you can beat the clock. Well, sure you can, all right. No, you can't use your hands. You can't put your hands down. You get through it there. There, put your foot up. Put your foot up. Well, up we go. There we are. All right, now you through. Now lift your arm. No, all right. Now lift through the other one, Mr. Foy, for goodness sake. All right, there we are. Hurry through the Mr. Foy. Darn it, I'm sorry you lost. You didn't beat the clock beat you. Mr. Foy, you made a darn good try, and Mrs. Foy, join the fire department. We have a very nice prize, the Sylvania Table Model Radio for you, in our appreciation of your grand effort.
Thank
Let's
you
give him
much.
Another nice hand there. Huh? Oh, thank you. All right, Roxanne, on a lovely evening gown. How are you there?
Fine, John.
So you're at the beach a minute ago. Who's our next contestant?
Yes, this is Mr. and Mrs. David Tidings from Louisville, Kentucky.
Louisville, Kentucky. Mr. and Mrs. Tidings, how are you, sir?
Just fine.
Good. Step right up by the microphone. Under this coat of green you're wearing, what do you do, sir?
I'm a naval man.
You're a naval man? You're a sailor?
Yes, sir.
What's your rating?
I'm a FA. I'm stationed aboard the USS Maury.
The USS Maury. And how long have you been married?
Since May 24th.
Uh-huh. This is sort of still a honeymoon then, is that right?
That's right.
Uh-huh. You are married since May 24th. You're in the Navy. And how'd you meet this lovely young lady?
Well, I was a Sunday school teacher.
And she was in the class?
I was supposed to be one of the chaperones on the Winnie Rolls.
Good. And you met her? Hot dog.
I just met her, yes, sir. Hot dog.
All right. Well, let's get right... Get right along. Wait a minute. There's the bonus question coming up. The bell rings, and you step right over here because you're going to get a chance to win $200 in cash. Bring out that bonus table here. Bring out the bonus table. There we are. Good for you, girls. Madeline over there and Betty and Mrs. Foy, you're right here. You're going fishing. Hold this with two hands. Face the audience, and I'll explain to Mr. Foy how you can win $200 just like that. Here we have a little stick with a thing on the end, and the object of this game, using only your one hand, you can't use both hands, is to get the plate up there. Let go a minute, honey. Just unbalance. Get the plate balanced up there and have the string taut. You get the idea? Let's see how many seconds we have to do this. We have 45 seconds to do it. You can only use one hand. Keep the other hand in back of you, and you can help most by just standing absolutely still. You get the idea? All right, ready, go. That's right, Mr. Foy. Hold it still there if you can. Mr. Foy. Hurry, boy. That's it. Now get it up there on the flat part. Mr. Foy. Go. All right, Mr. Foy. Let's go. Up. Go, Mr. Foy. Keep it still, dear. Keep it still. As still as you can. That's right, Mr. Foy. Hurry, Mr. Foy. There. Hurry, Mr. Foy. Mr. Foy. I'm sorry, but that still gives you a chance on the clock. You didn't lose anything. You didn't have to... Start trying to beat the clock right here with the $100 clock. Mrs. Foy, you stand there. Mr. Foy, you stand right there. And we're going to both work on this. You've done all the work. And the last thing, so this time you just watch and you'll do the work. You come on over. Come along with Mr. Foy right over here, cross stage. And we have the darndest thing you ever saw. All right. Pardon me. I beg your pardon. There we are. Why, Willie Hoppy, as I live and breathe. How do you do? There we are. Now, here's what we have to do, my dear. You're going to stand right up here on the edge, will you? Step right up, Mrs. Foy, and I'll show you how we do it. You hold the pool cue with two hands. That gives you a firmer grip on it. I will then take a cup filled with ordinary batter, like you would make waffles out, put it right there, and it's up to you to just sort of glide it over here and switch it over so it spills like that and catches on that peg, emptying the batter into the little container we have there, you see? And let me see how many seconds we have on this, on the clock there, shall we? You have a whole 40 seconds to do it, and it's really very easy. And all you have to do is watch, Mr. Foy. But I don't think you'll see anything over there, so you come over and lie down underneath here. All right. There we are. And put a bathing cap on our sailor friend there. There we are, Mr. Foy. Keep that now. Now, so you'll be able to see everything, we're going to put you in the most vital spot. You see, there's a hole in this thing right here, and I can see right down on Mr. Foy, and he'll be able to see if the batter comes pouring down. You get the idea? All right, we're all set to go here. Got a lot of cups of batter, so don't worry about a thing, Mrs. Foy. All right, there's the first one. I'll get out of the way because I wouldn't... And ready, go! That's it. Light it over there. Keep watching, Mr. Foy. Anything can happen. There we are. Give it a twist. Give it a pitch. There we are, Mr. Foy. You can't... You did a grand job. With the Wing Super Flash, flash bulbs, blue dots for sure shot. You better go out and get washed up, Mr. Foy. See, we made a mess out of him, didn't we? You did. I didn't do nothing about that. All right. We got through the $100 clock, and that's it. You did a good job. I tell you, that was real fine, Mrs. Foy, and I hope the rest is just as easy for you as that. Right now, We're working on the $100 clock on Beat the Clock for Mrs. Tidings, the sailor's wife. And Mrs. Tidings, you're all dressed for the next stunt, aren't you?
Right.
All right, now this time you have to do the work, but this is easy. Step right out here. We're going to try the $200 clock now. We won't need you, Mr. Tidings. Just stand there and rest. You've done all the work you need to. Now, all you have to do this time, Mrs. Tidings, what's your first name, dear?
Sarah.
Sarah, all right. Sarah, all you have to do this time is put this sock. Take two hands or one hand. Put this sock on that foot right there, the one towards the camera, so everybody can watch. Let me see how many seconds we have. Let's take a look at the clock over here. We have 50 seconds for that. That's all you have to do. Put the sock on the foot there. 50. All right. Oh, I forgot something. Oh, I did. I forgot. Yeah. You have to take this foot, though, and keep this helium-filled balloon down by holding your foot on top of it. You get the idea? While you're putting the sock on that foot. You get the idea? Because if you don't put your foot on top of it, it'll get away like that. Okay? All right. Put your foot right on the top there, and let's see what we got there. There we are. Good. There we are. Now put your... Are you ready? Go! Oh, wait a minute. Long toenails, kid. All right. Thank you very much. All right. There we are. Now ready? Oh. Wait. Let me see the bottom of your foot once. There we are. Good. Kid's wearing tacks. All right. Now here we go. Put your foot on there. Ready? Go! Into the... Right. Oh, boy, we're having a struggle here. Put your foot on there. Ready? Go! There we are. No, wait a minute. Go! All right. Wait a minute. We got to get together. All right, hold it. Wait a minute now. Hold your foot on there. There we are, girl. All right, now ready? Wait a minute. Bring another one out here. Stop the clock. Don't hold it so tight, you'll break it there. All right, now put your sock on that other foot there. Ready, go. Oh, wait a minute, stop. You're pressing a little hard, dear. But aren't we all? There we are. Now, just slide down to the floor with your hands there. That's right. And wait, keep your foot on this. Keep your foot on. There we are. Hurry up. Good. There we are. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Keep your foot on the balloon. There we are. Go. Wait a minute. Stop the clock. Mrs. Tidings, you got to concentrate on both. There we are. Now slide that sock on. You know, we've been on this for about 4 minutes, and the clock's only gone 7 seconds. Keep your foot on there gently, and now get into the... Mrs. Tidings. Wait a minute, Mrs. Tidings. All right, now try it again. Hold your foot on there gently, and let's see you slip the clock on. Go ahead. All right. There we are. Mrs. Tidings, stop the clock. There we are. Good. All right, Mrs. Tidings, and hold it gently. Hold it gently. There we are, Mrs. Tidings. Into the blue. There, wait a minute. Mrs. Tidings, do promise you'll try harder the next time. Wait a minute now. You got me doing it. Let's get serious, Mrs. Tidings. All right, ready. Go. Keep your foot on the balloon. Get the sock on. Hurry up, girl. The seconds are fleeting. This is tight. That's it, girl. Wait a minute. Ready? Go. Now, Mrs. Tidings, we only have about 15 seconds left here. All right, girl. All the way. That's it. Give her a hand. Mr. Tidings, you married a charming girl. Will you step over there a minute, because she's got to try for the jackpot all by herself. Out of range, because you can't help. You step over there, Mrs. Tidings. I'll explain to you what we're going to do. Wasn't it fun? All right. Now, back of this curtain here, we have our magnetized board on which are various words of a famous quotation or saying. When we pull the curtain aside, you've got to get the words in the right order to make the quotation the way it should be. You get the idea? All right, you have 20 seconds to do it in to win the jackpot. Ready? Open the curtain, step up there, and go. Hurry, Mrs. Tidings. Mrs. Tidings, hurry. Put them in the right order, Mrs. Tidings. Mrs. Tidings, the seconds are ticking. Oh, Mrs. Tidings. Oh, Mrs. Tidings, I'm sorry. It should be, don't put all your eggs in one basket. Mrs. Tidings, I'm sorry you didn't crack that one. I'm sorry you didn't win the jackpot. But I tell you what, you made a great effort, and we have something very nice we want you to see right over here.
From the King Refrigerator Corporation, a compact 4-cubic-foot freezer. which holds up to 150 pounds of frozen food. Your King freezer, which is worth its weight in cold, will save you time and money. Congratulations, Mr. and Mrs. Tidings. You've just won a Beat the Clock prize worth more than $200.
Thank you very much. What's that? Who do you have now? Hey, we got the Wild West here, haven't we? Who's this?
I'd like you to meet Mr. and Mrs. Mark Parker from Mesa, Arizona.
Right. Mark Parker and Mrs. Parker from Mesa, Arizona. How are you? Are you down here for a rodeo or something?
No, for a vacation.
For a vacation? Mm-hmm. And do you have a ranch out there?
We have a ranch in Mesa.
And how big a ranch do you have, Mrs. Parker?
45 acres.
45 mm-hmm. acres?
We have about 125 guests.
125? Oh, it's a sort of a ranch?
It's a guest ranch.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's
and
wonderful.
We came back here to find a real guest ranch, and we're staying at Cimarron.
Well, good for you.
And one of the nicest ranches here.
Well, they'll appreciate the plug.
I'm all set.
I hope they're watching. I hope so, too. Now, are you here with anybody else?
We have our group down here that we brought down from the ranch tonight.
Well, good for you. Now,
I'm also a photographer. I use any of bulbs. Of course, you wouldn't be interested in that.
Well, I want to thank you very much. That was very nicely put. Thank you. May I try the hat on just for...
Yeah, sure.
All right.
On you, it looks good.
On me, it looks good. No, I just thought it might fit. I didn't know. All right, let's get right to our $100 clock on Beat the Clock here in the Sylvania program. And we have a very easy one for this. Would you mind taking off your boots, sir?
Taking off my boots?
Yeah, and you come right around here, ma'am, and sit in this chair over here on the far side. You can leave your hat on. I think it looks very lovely. I didn't mean to imply. You sit right there. And your husband is taking off his boots. Mr. Parker's right here. And Mr. Parker, this is one of the easiest things you ever did see. You have a phone out at your ranch?
Oh, absolutely.
All right. Now, when I say go, it is up to you, sir, and you too, Mrs. Parker, both of you, to take your feet off the floor. You don't have to put them in your chair or anything. Hold on to the sides of the chairs. Keep your feet off the floor from then on during the whole contest. You, sir, will then pick up this telephone receiver with your 2 feet. You will swivel the chair around that way. And while you're doing that, you will swivel the chair around this way, and then you will feed her the phone, and she will take it, and she will swivel around that way, and I'll be right over here to get the phone. See, in New York, we do it differently. Pardon me? What?
I swivel around this way?
Well, you'd never know it. All right? Pardon me? Yes, it certainly does. All right. All right. Now, let's see how many seconds we have on the clock over here for this little one. 55 seconds, all the time in the world. Are you ready?
Ready.
Go! The phone's ringing. You can't touch the floor with your feet, sir. You got to swivel around on your... No, no, not with you. That's it. That's it. Swivel. Sort of shake it a little bit, Mr. Parker. There we are, boy. That's it, Mr. Parker. Now, wait a minute. Stop the clock. You don't get the idea, Mr. Parker. We'll take it again from the top. Yeah, what was that, sir?
I see, the chassis is not running.
Well, you're doing fine. Now, it'll twist out. Now, we'll get right back here to this position, see? I want you to have room enough there. The doctor will be with you in a minute. Now, are you ready, Mr. Parker? Ready? Go! That's it. Pick up the phone. Give it a big twist. That's that phone. All right, Mr. Parker, get your feet up there. Get that telephone. Get that telephone away from him. Don't drop the phone, whatever you do. I tell you. Hello, hello. Yeah, there we are. All right, now you can go around that way. I'm over here waiting for you. Mrs. Parker, hurry up. This way, girl. Hurry, hurry. Mrs. Parker, come on. Hurry, Mrs. Parker, the second. I want to ask you something. You're a cowboy. Do you do any singing, sir?
No, sir. I'm not a singing cowboy.
You're not a singing cowboy. Well, we're
I just
not
telephone.
We're not going to ask. Limp Along King welcomes you back to the Sylvania program. All right. Now, we are all ready to assault the $200 clock, right?
Fine.
Mr. Parker and wife, will you step this way? You have your boots back on, and this is going to make... You stand here, Mrs. Parker. And, Mr. You brought your lunch in a box. Good. All right. And you, Mr. Parker, stand over here facing this way, sir. Don't go so far away. We have very narrow cameras. Now, what we're going to do is ask both of you to put your hands behind you during this, because you will not need your hands. And we have these two boxes, and we want you to come a little closer, Mr. Parker, so that we are pressing the two boxes together between you. Now, we daren't drop the boxes to the floor, because that'll stop the clock. But all you have to do is get this box without using your hand on your head, and this box on your head. You can use your knees or anything you want to do, but you can't use your hands, and if you drop it on the floor, that stops the clock. Now, let's see how many seconds you have. Let's see what the time is on the clock. 40 seconds, all the time in the world. Ready, go. All right, there we are, into the... wait a minute, wait a minute, Parker. Ms. Parker, are you there? All right, Ms. Parker. Oh, I was worried about her. Mrs. Parker, come on back. You look better with your hat on. Come on back. All right. Mrs. Parker, may I suggest to both of you that you should use your knees a little bit on this and get your chin into the play. Yeah, you're a little bit taller, so you can use your chin, too. All right, you ready, Mr. Parker?
Tell me.
Mr. Parker,
yeah.
Let's shake hands while we're still friends. All right, ready? Go!
That's all right, yes.
Wait a minute. Mrs. Parker threw some... Mr. Parker.
Yeah.
Hi, old boy. No.
Come on out.
We know you. Right. I'm sorry. You can't use your hands, too, dear. Put your hands behind you. She didn't mean to. She was just... But she threw it so hard it went over her head.
It's all right. In the bag.
Yeah, it's just in the bag. All right, ready? Go. We won't need you for this. She's got to do this one by herself. She's going to try for the jackpot. Thank you, sir. Oh, here's your hat. I beg your pardon. Mrs. Parker, step right over there, and I'll explain to you what we're going to do. Behind the curtain here, we have our magnetic board with the dispersed and all wrinkled out words of a famous saying or quotation. We have 20 seconds for you to put the words in the proper order and do it good now, girl, because I want to see you win the jackpot. Everybody rooting for you. All right. Open the curtain. Step up there and go. Yes, Mrs. Parker. Quickly. Quickly. Oh. Hurry, Mrs. Parker. Oh, Mrs. Parker. Oh, I'm sorry, Mrs. Parker. Let me show you what it should have been. Fools rush in where angels fear to tread. I'm sorry you didn't get that. I'm sorry you didn't get the jackpot. You didn't beat the clock. The clock beat you. But wait a minute. Come right down here. You're not going away empty-handed. We have a very lovely present for you. And let's look and see what it is.
A beautiful fashion trend bedroom group from the Johnson Carper Furniture Company of Roanoke, Virginia. Your Ivory Carina fashion trend suite is designed especially for young moderns with good taste. Congratulations, Mr. and Mrs. Barker. You have just won a Beat the Clock prize worth more than $200.
All right, folks. Congratulations to both of you. Thank you very much. Job. Roxanne, who are our next contestants on the Pennsylvania Beat the Clock? Who are these people?
John, our next contestants are Mr. and Mrs. John Noddy from East Orange, New Jersey.
All right, Mr. and Mrs. Noddy, what do you do?
Well, right now I'm not doing anything.
You're not doing much of anything, I see. What are you planning to do?
I'm planning to go into the service.
Into the service. How long have you been married?
3 months.
3 months. Oh, well, it's a bride and groom. I wasn't there at the wedding, so I'll kiss you now. All right. Now, well, let's get right to work, shall we, on the prizes? All right. On the $100 clock, you come out of here. We'll need you both. And we're going to do like the milkman does early in the morning. You hold one hand on this side, and you, sir, come around here and hold one hand on this side. And we have two milk bottles here, and what you have to do is jiggle it and fit the bottle in any one of these things, you see? To get in there, any one of these bottles in there, and you let's see how many seconds we have there. On the clock, we have 55 seconds to jiggle the bottle in, so ready? Huh? It can be right side up or wrong side up. Ready? Go! You gotta get two bottles in here in the 45 seconds. Only with one hand now, that's right. There we are. Yeah. Give it a little shake. That's it. Not too hard. We almost had it in. Jiggle it. A little more. Miss him. All right. Go ahead. Get the next one in there. There we are. See, you can do it to beat the clock. Come on now, boy. Oh, those seconds are ticking away. Mr. and Mrs. Noddy. Oh! Wait a minute. wait a minute. We ran out of time. I'm sorry. Can you come back next week?
Yes, sir.
Well, I tell you what. We ran out of time, and you can go home and practice. Wait up for the milkman some morning earlier. Go down there and borrow the basket. You can practice on this. And I want to thank you, and we'll be looking for you next week, okay? Thank you very much. But right now, we have run out of time, and it's time to go. And this is John Reed King from my good friend Bud Collyer, hoping that next time will be your time to beat the clock. Good night, everybody.
CBS Television Network. Roxanne Gone, Larry Aldrich, original. Rowboat, courtesy of Chris Craft Motorboat Sales. This is Vern Bennett reminding you to tune in every week at the same time for Beat the Clock.